Howdy everybody, ArgonMatrix here, welcome to episode 35 of Bloodborne. We're back in this little nook of the DLC area, the Hunter's Nightmare, where this beast man is standing watch over our blood echoes in there. And I hope to give him the what for this time. I don't know how well I'm going to do here, it's been a little while since I recorded this, and I've played a lot of Dark Souls 3 in the interim, so as I'm sure many people could probably attest to, going back and forth between Dark Souls 3 and Bloodborne is kind of a nightmare, just because the combat systems like feel very similar in certain ways, but very, very different in other ways. So I'm gonna try to stay on my toes here. I had a little bit of practice just in trying to get back to this area. I have also come to the conclusion that this shortcut that I opened previously does not actually let you get back here, so I did have to just go back the same way that I've always been. Okay. We're actually doing not so terrible so far. I mean, I'm about to die, though, so get your shit together. Back off if you really need to, and then do one of these. Oh, yeah, that feels good. Maybe try and get a visceral attack in at some point if you can, but don't tempt fate, I guess. That's what I'm saying there. Oh, shit! Oh, I had him! I had that visceral attack all lined up and ready to go, but I just didn't trust myself enough to actually, like, go through with it, I guess. Okay, stand back. Oh, don't get in the corner now. He does so much damage, dude. Maybe I need, like, better armor or something for protection against beasts. Who knows? Physical damage reduction or some crap, I don't know. Oh, nice shot, nice shot. Nice shot, nice shot. good shots, but no visceral attacks. We're putting the heat on. That much we cannot deny here. The problem is, like, three direct hits from him, and I'm just gonna die. So I have to still be careful, even at this point. You can't get greedy. It's the name of the game. Is never get greedy in Bloodborne, or Dark Souls, or... Oh, shit. Shit! No! Are you kidding? Did you see... Oh man, well, it's a good warm-up session anyway. I'll be back at that guy in a moment. Alright, I figured I'd cut in sort of towards the end of the fight here, just because we've seen me die to this guy enough times that I don't trust myself to do the whole fight in one go anymore. And I may just die again here. Oh, he got caught on the stairs, hell yeah. See, like, the instant I started doing, like, a lot worse at this. So much so that I may yet die. Wait, oh, he's so close. He's like just a gunshot away, but I didn't have my gun ready, so I just did a heavy attack instead. Bow down to him, though. That's not a bow. This is a hunter salutation right here. Wait for it. There it goes. All right. Should not have been that hard to take that guy down, but there it is. We got the firing hammer badge, which is sort of equivalent to the powder keg badge we got earlier, except from a bygone era, I suppose. Let's transform this back. Let's get this off the screen, and let's have a look at it really quick. I forget what it actually lets you buy from the shop. Would it be in here? Kaner's firing hammer badge from the old auto workshop. The powder kegs were driven by singular ideas and crafted strange weapons of great intricacy. It is clear that the philosophy of the powder kegs was already established at this time by the auto workshop, which is a very strange name. I don't know, there's something just ominous about it, I guess. Speaks to me. You only ever hear about the auto workshop in the DLC, I'm pretty sure, so it was kind of a new thing they added. Alright, so back out this door, it leads to the River of Blood area, which is where the shortcut takes us. Now, that's one hunter done with, but would you believe it? There's actually another one in the not too distant future here. You just have to follow the River of Blood far enough down. I mean, I might just straight up die to these guys. Okay. This is scary, because I didn't want two of them on me at once, let alone three. Yeah. That's about right. You know, a smarter man would take all this death and destruction of my personal well-being as an indication that I should not be in this area yet, that I should go to do other areas and level up and then come back to this when I'm more well-equipped. I'm not a smart man, though. Not in that regard, anyway. I'm stubborn as hell. So we are going to go ahead and keep trying here, at least accumulate enough blood echoes to level up, hopefully, once or twice, and then maybe we'll be in a little bit of a better position. Although one or two levels are probably not going to make the difference that we hope to see in the world here. Maybe I just need to upgrade my weapons more, honestly. That's the thing, is that we're actually very, very close to being able to acquire the weapon that I want to replace the Hunter's Axe with. It's actually, like, at the end of the River of Blood here. It's not too far away at all. So I don't really want to invest in more upgrading of the Hunter's Axe when I know it's about to be replaced. And it's a little bit sad to say that, just like, the Hunter's Axe has been with us through thick and thin through all this nonsense we put ourselves through. We got the Constable's gloves, so hold that thought, you silly. Oh, I gotta use this. God, I tell you, man, the controls for Dark Souls 3 are so radically different, but yet so very similar. Where are these Constable's gloves? There they are. Once upon a time, a great way to start a story, a troop of foreign constables chased a beast all the way to Yharnam, and this is what they wore. The constables became victims of the beast, except for one survivor, who in turn devoured the creature whole, all by himself. Holy shit. The fable is a favorite among Yharnamites, who are partial to any stories of pompous, intolerant foreigners who suffer for their ignorance. It makes the blood taste that much sweeter. There you go. Fairy tales from the macabre library, I guess. Alright, so let's go ahead and try and get our echoes back here. Actually, coming across this bridge from this direction is not nearly as bad as going across from the other direction that we previously had to actually unlock the shortcut. So now these guys don't see us coming, so we can actually get the jump on them pretty nicely here. Oh, did I have them? No, I didn't, so just shoot them. When in doubt, shoot. That's the American way, man, and the Yharnam way, apparently. Alright, wait for this guy. Actually, this guy might just see me out right when I walk over this way. Oh, apparently not. Can I sneak up behind him and get a nice old visceral attack on him? Restore my bullets. I actually did, in between videos, swap out some runes and stuff. I put on the Hunter Oath rune, which increases stamina speed recovery. Or stamina recovery speed, rather. I also swapped out for the Odin Writhe rune, I think, which, gives me quicksilver bullets on visceral attacks, so I'm gonna try to handle these guys one at a time, if possible. Sometimes they just don't let you, and these versions of the blood lickers actually have ranged attacks now, so you can't back off and heal as much as you might have been used to against the ones that we fought in Kaner's castle. Thankfully, they're pretty easily staggered, and if you can get around behind them, you don't have too much to worry about. They do have a kick attack that they do sometimes. So be wary of that, at the very least. I'm gonna try and shoot this guy and grab his attention. And hopefully, I can back off enough to get him... Oh, he's actually, like, sitting on top of my blood echoes. Alright, he did not seem interested in me. He's more interested in guarding his little spawn spot over there. Oh, shit. I wasn't sure if I got both their attention or not. I think I'm okay. If I stand too close, though, I might end up, getting that other guy's aggro as well. No, he's fine. You actually have to get pretty close to these guys in order to make them mad, so don't worry so much about it. Despite the fact that there are like a million of them around here, you can actually be fairly close and not have to worry about it. Get our blood echoes back here. It's kind of hard to notice in all the blood, but... Alright. Now this guy is being a problem. So don't stand in front of them. That's what we should have learned by now. Stand behind them, or behind them to the side as much as you can, because that's like the best spot, because then they can't kick you, but they also can't like scratch you. It's kind of the best of both worlds. 41,000 echoes. I really should pop back to Hunter's Dream in a second, but I gotta take one crack at this little upcoming area that we got here. I think... Yeah, I can actually get this guy's attention without drawing that other guy's attention, which is the main thing that I want here, because it's very easy to get both their attentions at the same time if you're not being careful. Okay. Oh, he was moved for a moment. He was moved by my gunshot. It's a very sentimental gunshot. I'm gonna go ahead and heal up just in case. I'm using more blood vials than I would like just to get to this area, especially given that the area is difficult enough that I'm going to have to use blood vials to even stand a chance in hell of succeeding in it. My god, so much blood, dude. any area that warranted the name of this game being Bloodborne, you're looking at it here. Maybe the long hunter's axe is the way to go against these guys, because it gives me some distance against them. Transformed attack is also pretty good. There we go. Managed to deal with that guy fairly easily. Sorry for that sound. That was my phone. I usually put that on silent. I guess I forgot. Got a warm, damp blood gem. Ew. Don't want to know where that's been. I think that's the last of those blood liquors, though. Oh, there's a nightmare imp. Gotta grab that. Don't run too far, though. Because you will regret it if you do. My god, this guy's resilient. That should be an indication that I definitely don't need to be here. That's two bloodstone chunks, though. Like, holy shit. Okay, so you want to make sure to have a gun equipped so that you can actually parry and stuff. But it is very dark in this area. But it's about to be lit up quite nicely, if I remember right, once we step close enough here. Because this guy's got a fucking Gatling gun mounted on his hand. We face off against one of these guys before, but he didn't have the Gatling gun on his arm. He had it mounted up on a building. So this makes for a very tough fight, I will say. The Gatling gun can really easily combo you. That's kind of, it's kind of nice that they have this pillar here to, okay. I may just eat shit here and die. That's probably what's about to happen, but I do want to beat this hunter. If I can beat this hunter, he should actually not respawn, because as most hunters don't, like that beast man that we beat a little earlier in the video, will not respawn either. Nice hit, nice hit. But you can see that we're not doing that much damage to him either. Plus, if I lose my lock on, it can be hell itself, because you guys may be able to see this fight a little better than I can right now, because the video brightness is going to be better than my TV brightness, probably. At the same time, it's still dark as hell. And maybe it would behoove me to actually use the torch in here. I don't know. I'm probably not going to be getting too many visceral attacks on this guy, if I had to guess. This is kind of the strategy that I've used in the past to deal with him, is if I can lure him into doing that Gatling gun. He walks fairly slow when he does it, which gives me plenty of time to unleash with that spin attack on him. It feels a little cheesy, maybe, but he's a tough enough opponent that I feel kind of justified in it. Especially once he does that shit, he heals up. I actually was surprised that hit him. I thought I was just going to ping against the wall, you know, as you often do. Okay, don't lose lock on him. Oh, shit! Okay, that's the one issue, is that there are some areas where he can kind of get a deadlock on you and just combo you into oblivion. Honestly, though, when you're outmatched this heavily, I think it's a fair to use as many underhanded tactics as you can. I'm normally a much more honorable fighter than this. I hope I've made that clear throughout the rest of the game. And this is not a foolproof strategy either. Like, I may well still die here. Plus, this guy's not the only thing in this little cavern. Thankfully, he's, like, alone when you face him here. Damn it. But beyond him, there's more nonsense to be had. So, I'll be back and hopefully be able to acquire my blood echoes without too much hassle there. Okay, guys, I'm back, and I'm not exactly where you might expect me to be. I'm in this little chapel down to the right of the Grand Cathedral, where this lovely lady here took us to the Nightmare Frontier at one point. And why am I back here instead of in the DLC area, you ask? Well, I was saying that I think the DLC area is probably a little too much for me right now. And I don't say that lightly. It's like you don't need to know the story of what happened. Because I did go back and try to get those blood echoes back. You can see that it did not go so well by my blood echo count up in the corner there. And I realized that, you know, part of being able to conquer a game like Bloodborne or Dark Souls or whatever is realizing when you are not up to the challenge. Even though I've done the DLC area, and I'm sure that if I kept, like, grinding it out for a little while, then I could do the DLC area. Like, I feel like I'm at a strong enough point. I can show you my stats here. It's not the greatest in the world, it's probably a little under level for the DLC, but I'm probably going to head back there when I'm closer to level 70-ish. When I'm getting towards the later part of the game, like towards the very end of the game, we'll probably head back there and finish that off. So just consider the past video and a half or so, like a little teaser. Actually, it was like more like two videos and a half, wasn't it? little more of an investment when you put it that way, I guess. But regardless, we are going to go ahead and continue in Yahar'gul Unseen Village here instead, which is where we are effectively meant to be for right now. This is where the story has led us up to this point. It's the Blood Moon. After defeating Rom the Vacuous Spider, we were dropped off here, told the Nightmare Seal has been breached or some such thing. Something of that caliber, you know? And it just didn't sound good in general, so let's go ahead and... Now, that being said, that, like, I was probably not well prepared for the DLC area, this area is still a bitch. I'm not gonna lie about that. This is a tough, tough area that you really need to be ready for, and you need to know kind of what the deal is with this area if you want to stand much of a chance here. We got the Iron Yahar'gul helm there, so I think that's part of a set that we already kind of have. The Yahar'gul set here. Oh god, Siri activated somehow, and she's recording everything that I'm saying right now. She said, "I'll pretend I didn't hear that." I don't know what I said to justify that, Siri, but goddamn. Yeah, you can see this is just the hooded Iron Helm. This is the regular Iron Helm. Not too much of consequence there. There are a lot of these amygdala things here, though, so be on your guard. A lot of them will not grab you or will not be in a good enough vantage point to grab you. Can't really do anything with this elevator, unfortunately. Not yet. It's a shortcut for another day, I suppose. Oh god. This is the main thing with this area, though, is that these dudes respawn without you having to go to the lantern, like, to go to Hunter's Dream and back. They will just keep on coming back because there are bell-ringing women out there bringing them back. That's kind of the ticket here. It's similar to, I don't know how many of you have watched the Chalice Dungeons, those videos, but it's similar to the bell-ringing woman in... there's the staircase. I thought I was going crazy for a second. Similar to the bell ringing women in the Chalice Dungeons who spawn like a bunch of little dopey minions and bring them back constantly. So you can see the staircase is kind of infested. If you look down far enough, there's like a lot of these guys, and they will all be respawned by a bell ringing woman. That's a nice sight, though. So what I'm gonna actually do, this is the way I normally handle this area, is I kinda like bum rush past all these guys as best I can. And it's gonna kite a lot of them, like we're gonna have a fucking army following us in a second here. But I know the location of the bell ringing woman. So I want to go ahead and track her down. She's right up here. She's a little bit tough herself sometimes. Finish her off, and then the rest of them will just sort of, they won't fall like they do in the Chalice Dungeon when you kill the bell ringer. They don't all just die, but now they will not come back when you kill them. They're all kind of staggered for a moment as well, just kind of your indication that you've done something right, you know. It's similar to in Dark Souls games, like they have necromancers sometimes who bring back all hordes of skeletons. This is that game's equivalent, except instead of skeletons, they are blood-ravaged, hairy men. For lack of a better term, I guess. Alright, so I don't really need to go back and clear all these guys out, I suppose, but you know what? The bloodlust is with me now. I do need to do it for my own sanity. I have to be careful on this staircase, though, because there is a part of it where the amygdala clinging to the building above will try and grab me. It is one of the ones that does attempts to do that anyway. Nice shot, Tex. Asshole. Alright, these guys usually don't drop anything either. I think on rare occasions they can drop blood vials and stuff, but because they're like respawning enemies, they tend not to. Regardless, so that is the first bell ringing woman, because it would be too easy to only have like one of those little traps, wouldn't it? This feels familiar. Got a bolt damp blood gem there, that's kind of cool. What do these notes say? The Mensis ritual must be stopped, lest we all become beasts. I'd give that a fine rating if I could. Nothing but small gents here. Talk about tonally dissonant. Treat man with care. Look at this little man over here. Aww. He died doing what he loved. Whatever the hell that is. I don't know. He's prostrate in some position there. At any rate. Head on out this way. We have like a little bit of a break here before we have to deal with the next sort of section of the bell ringing woman. Thankfully, this section is not quite as bad. This does not open from this side. because the Bellring Woman is fairly close in this one. But you do have to deal with like an ogre in here, I think. Or not, well, it's, I don't think it's actually, yeah, it's one of these guys. So you can finish him off if you want. Actually, I probably should. We got the air rune, hell yeah. Okay, this is, I've got myself in a bit of a tough situation here with these two enemies, but this guy's actually not that bad. He should die in like two hits or so, hopefully. The nastiest thing about all these like blood ravaged enemies that get brought back by the bell-ringing women is that they do a lot more damage than their fleshy counterparts. So keep that in mind. But I should probably deal with this guy, even though he will be brought back. I'll check out that air rune in a second. I don't fully remember what the air rune does. I know we've had had them in the past, but that's the most upgraded one, probably. What the? That was a freaking no-scope headshot. Props to you, my wheelchair-mounted friend. My lord. Alright, we're back here in the approximate area of my death. Just past these bars here. Now let's not let whatever happened last time happen again, hopefully. This guy... See, he's not even summoned this time. I guess I gave him too much time last time. Let's deal with him here. Then we'll deal with the Bellring Woman, and should be easy as that. Alright. Really a bit of a foolhardy death on my part. I don't know if it was foolhardy or more just unlucky that I happened to get hit in the head, which apparently does a lot more damage. Frenzied Cold Blood there. I did check out the air rune in between cuts there, by the way. It increases the amount of blood echoes that we receive from visceral attacks, which is pretty sweet, but I don't really think I need it at this juncture. I will go ahead and open up this door over here, though, to make it a little easier coming through here in the future if we need to, because we'll just be able to walk right here, and the Bellring Woman, it will be literally beyond that door. Now, this next area coming up gave me a lot of grief when I first came through the game, my first playthrough here, because I didn't really know about these Bellring Women, or at least I kind of, like, managed to infer it from like the past couple sections, but the one from this area is pretty well hidden. So what you gotta do, if I remember right, I'm not gonna head over that way. You gotta kind of here. I'm gonna save you a lot of time and grief in doing this yourself if you're like playing along here. You wanna head over this way, go to this little gap in the fence, and drop on down, because this will take you to right near the Bellring Woman. In fact, I think this is actually the only way to really get to the Bellring Woman. One of these guys that we gotta deal with, so that's lovely. Uh-huh, okay, that's about right. Go ahead and heal up. There might actually be a second one in here, like, right behind me, so I'm not positive on that, but it's, probably not worth the risk. Okay, there's the Bellring Woman right there. So let's go ahead and get her knocked out, because that should stagger this guy for a moment. And that might be long enough for us to deal a hefty amount of damage here. So one little visceral attack should be able to do the trick. Or if we just swing with aplomb, 777 damage, baby. That's the stuff I'm talking about. Some quicksilver bullets here. So that'll make things a lot easier in this little area, because there are so many enemies that she would have been bringing back. Because she's like underneath the ground here, and it's like right in the epicenter of where everything is. So she would just be bringing everybody back. Is there a spot where I can kind of drop down here as well? I think if I drop down right here to get to this item attached to this fantastically dressed gentleman. Look at this guy, he's like a regular Christopher Columbus. The Upper Cathedral Key, which actually opens up a whole nother area to us. The upper echelons of the Healing Church are formed by the School of Mensis based upon the Unseen Village and the Choir, or based in the Unseen Village, and the Choir occupying the Upper Cathedral Ward. This key brings one a step closer to the choir. So this would have been a long time ago at this point, but way back when we were first exploring Cathedral Ward, like just after we beat Bloodstar Beast, actually, and we opened up the little elevator outside of Cathedral Ward, we climbed all the way up, we got the Ludwig's like holy sword, hunter badge, or whatever the hell it was, and there was a locked door up there. This is the key that unlocks that door all this fucking time later. We got a tiny Tinnitus, though. So let's focus on the here and now. I thought I heard a guy behind me. Shit, yep. All right, that's a hell of a guy, too. All right, didn't want to have to take that while I was reading about my tiny Tinnitus. Speaking of, Let me see here. I think it's one of these magic items that I can't really use. Yeah, we need 25 arcane to use that. But it is a this small Morningstar mace that that utilizes Quicksilver bullets. When struck through the ground, it creates blue sparks that are said to surround like the Dark Beast. Like Archibald's masterpiece, this too is a superb conductor of the powerful blue sparks. So this is actually a very, very powerful item if you have the stats to use it. I've done like an arcane run in the past, just on my own, and managed to get to use that, and that was a lot of fun, let me tell you what. Alright, so now we can head out this way, and this actually works out pretty well, because this is kind of the lowest point, like the lowest sort of dead end that you would reach if you came around here to another from another area. Hello, gorgeous! Well, I'm ready for my close-up. Oh god, its head just like turned all the way around. Oh, that's a little disturbing. Thankfully that one doesn't have the wherewithal to grab me here, so thank goodness for that. Now, I think there's like a bunch of ladies. I don't know, maybe they all just died because I killed the bellring woman. That doesn't seem quite right though, but normally they're like all surrounding this dude doing some sort of ritual, I guess. Oh, hidden path, therefore time for falls. See, that's pointing right to the fence gate, so I'll definitely give that a fine. Because that's a bit of a tough thing to find out on your own. You don't need to do that, mind you. Just taking out the Bellring Woman is not necessary by any means, but it'll make things a lot easier for this area, because there's so much going on, as you're about to see, in this this little plaza that we got here. I'm gonna go ahead and sneak up on these wenches. Good shit. I try to get a visceral attack there just to see if I can get something out of it. Wow! Oh, apparently even without the Bellring Woman to assist them, they're too much for me, I guess. Holy shit. Alright guys, I'm back in this area. I have dispatched of the Bellring Woman. Hopefully these ladies will not get my goat this time. I already got my blood echoes back because it was kind of on the way to the Bellring Woman as is. I'm going to go back around this way this time and see if I can, because these were the ones that actually managed to get me before because they snuck up from the side. Oh god, I don't even know where that one came from. As long as I don't get like pincer trapped like I did last time, I should be good here. So they don't do nearly that much damage to be too much of a threat to me. Except in large numbers, as we saw previously. Alright, what do we got here, though? Bloodstone Chunk, I'm all for that. Yeah, unfortunately, having sort of chickened out on the DLC area does mean I won't be getting my new weapon for a little while. But that's okay. My god. These ladies, though. Also, did you see the fucking laser beam that happened earlier? Yeah. We did fight, It's pretty much the same thing as the laser beam that we had to deal with in the fight against the actual Amygdala boss. So this one, yeah, this Amygdala up here will actually just keep on lasering, but it lasers in the same pattern every time. It does like the sort of zigzag pattern up these stairs over here. And as long as you're not in an area that has been lasered, or like you're not standing on top of an area that's been lasered, you should be good. And it can actually hit these ladies as well. They happen to move into the exact right spots. If I stand here, though, I should be safe. And we just kind of gotta book it down. It's not even like a one-hit KO if that thing hits you, by the way. And the laser itself does no damage, I don't think. So that's fine. But if you can make it this far, then peace be with you. You have found a lantern. And it's actually a lantern in a sort of familiar area to us, because if you look down here, you can see... It's kind of hard to tell, but that statue over there has a lantern at its foot too, and that's the Hypogean Jail lantern that we initially came to the Unseen Village through back before the Blood Moon and all that. So that's quite interesting. But if you manage to make it through this gauntlet, then and you've seen just about the worst of it. I think the Unseen Village just gets a little bit easier from here. Not easy, mind you, but easier. Regardless, I think that's gonna be more than enough for one video. I have a lot of stuff to cut out, I know. My recordings are like 50 minutes of those, so should be plenty. That's gonna be it for today, so I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Next time we will continue through the Unseen Village and see what terrors await us. I might actually make a smart decision for once in my life and go back to Hunter's Dream and spend these blood echoes on something. instead of just squandering them every time. I've lost like 100,000 blood echoes over the course of these two videos thanks to that DLC area. But I digress. For now, I'm gonna head out of here, so thanks for watching. This is ArgonMatrix signing out. Thank you and good night. Wait, almost forgot. There we go. Thank you and good night.